whenever you're ready.
All right. I'm always ready. I'm just kidding. All right, and action. All right, guys, Mr. Medellin here, Mr. M, and today we're gonna do a quick video on filtration. So we're gonna be covering inherent filtration, added filtration, and total filtration. And the textbook that we're using, of course, is gonna be the Principles book. It's this one right here. It's the Principles of Radiographic Imaging, and we're in chapter 11 for you guys that have this book. There's been a couple other students from different programs reaching out, and again, I asked what textbook you're using. So if you're not using the Principles book, maybe you have the Bouchon's book or another type of radiographic imaging book, you're gonna find a chapter just on filtration inside that text, okay? So let's go ahead and get started. So first thing we're gonna do is I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna draw the x-ray tube. So the glass tube is gonna look like this here, all right? So here is the glass. This glass is gonna be Pyrex glass. And Pyrex, as you know, is used for cooking. It can withstand a lot of heat. That's the reason for Pyrex glass being used. I heard this one time, I don't know if it's true, but supposedly we got it from NASA. I don't know if that's true, we'll have to fact check that, but it'd be pretty cool if we did. So the Pyrex glass is gonna be what's gonna be known as the glass envelope. So the glass envelope holds two components, the cathode and the anode. So the anode would be on this end here, and then the cathode would be here on this side. Okay, so this would be the cathode. So the cathode has a negative charge, and the anode has a positive charge, correct? So again, we've gone over the x-ray tube on another video, but again, we're gonna keep this just primarily focused on filtration, okay? So we have the glass envelope. This is the Pyrex glass. And then there's an insulating oil as well. So the insulating oil, along with the Pyrex glass, is gonna be known as inherent filtration. So I'm gonna make that blue right here. So the glass and the oil, I'll put that here. The glass and the oil is gonna be known as inherent filtration. Okay, so inherent filtration is gonna be the glass and the oil. So what I'm gonna do is, I'll go ahead and I'll make this blue right here, just like that, how about that? Then underneath it, we're gonna have another device that has a sheet of aluminum here. There's a sheet of aluminum. So this is aluminum, AL. And then we have a box. And that box is gonna be known as your collimator. So your collimator is known as a beam restriction device. A beam limitation device, all right? So a beam limitation device is gonna restrict the size of the field of exposure. So we use the light when you're positioning your patient. We use the light as a guide to tell us where we're at because we work off the shadow effect, correct? So the beam limitation device or your collimator allows us to limit the area of exposure to only the area that's needed for the procedure, for the exam. You only want to include the anatomy of interest, the area of diagnosis, the site of injury. That's what we're focused on, okay? So the collimator allows us to limit the size of the field to just the area of the clinical interest, all right? So that's the purpose of the collimator. Now, I'll tell you what the purpose of filtration is in just a minute, but we're gonna go ahead and talk about the collimator. Inside the collimator, you have two sets of lead shutters. So you have lead shutters. You're gonna have a glass mirror inside that's gonna reflect the light down. And then we have an aluminum framing. So let's go ahead and I'll make these different colors. We'll make this green here. So we have the glass mirror, we have lead shutters, and then we have the aluminum framing inside of the collimation device. So all these devices here are gonna be known as added filtration. So added filtration is gonna be the sheet of aluminum, aluminum framing, glass mirror, and the two sets of lead shutters. So if you have inherent filtration and you have added filtration, well then when you add them up, they're gonna give us what's called total filtration. So if you had the glass and the oil and the added filtration, then they're gonna give us what's called total filtration. So the total filtration is the combination of the glass envelope and the oil and the added filtration, and that's gonna give us total. So we're gonna throw in a little bit of math here, but nothing too complicated. We're gonna have the glass and oil. That's gonna be about 0.5 millimeter of aluminum equivalent. All right, so we got 0.5. Then for the added filtration, that's gonna have an equivalency as well. And that's gonna be 2.0 of millimeter aluminum equivalent. Now notice that the glass and the oil is not made out of aluminum, but they use it to compare it to an absorbing material such as aluminum. So that's where you get aluminum equivalent. So you have 2.0 for added, you have 0.5, and then for total filtration, let's go back to red here. All right, so you got 0.5, and then we have 2.0. And if you add them together, we got 2.5 millimeter of aluminum equivalent for total filtration. So, we're in LA, hey. All right, so there's always somebody honking or something going on here. So, total filtration, again, is the combination of the inherent, and inherent means built in or manufactured in, right? Added to something that we add to it. So the total filtration is 2.5 millimeter aluminum equivalent because we operate with systems that go above 70 kVp. All right. Now, there's another term that's in the textbook, excuse me, goes by HVL. So filtration sometimes is related to what's called HVL. So HVL, let's put this on the board here. HVL stands for half value. You remember the other part? It's gonna be layer, that's right, half value layer. So half value layer is any absorbing material that reduces the intensity, okay, the intensity of energy to half the original value. So instead of saying half like this, you can say that it reduces it by 50% of the value. Okay, so a half value layer is any absorbing material that reduces the intensity of radiation to half. All right, and that's a half value layer. So I've seen in some of the review questions, you know, how many half value layers would it take to reduce the intensity to below like 10%, let's say. So if you have a half value layer that reduces it by 50%, that's one, right? So again, another is gonna be, let's say you go from 100 to 50, and then you go from 50 to 25, then you go 25 to 12.5, you would have to add like four half value layers to reduce it to get to below, let's say 10%, all right? So, but again, the half value layer is reducing the intensity of radiation by half. Now, there's other filters out there and they're called compensating filters. We'll do a separate video that's gonna describe the anode Hill effect because that's when you would apply a compensating filter. A compensating filter, just to throw some information out there, is used when you have a body part that is non-uniform. You have an unequal thickness of the body part, and because of the anode Hill effect, that was more prevalent, you guys, with film-based systems that we had. It's not as common with DR systems. I gotta tell you that I'm hoping that the ART will change that soon because you really can't see the anode Hill effect on the DR systems. We've tried it, you know, but back in the days in film, you could tell the difference. But compensating filters are used because there's an unevenness of the intensity of the energies and an unevenness of the thickness of the part, and then that's why they would use a compensating filter. But we'll do a separate video for that. The purpose of the filtration is to remove. So filtration now removes low energy X-rays from reaching the patient. So remember wavelengths. So you want a short wavelength versus a long wavelength because those are the ones that just get absorbed by the patient. So you want to have a short, hard energy going through the patient. So what filtration does is that it removes the lower energies from hitting the patient. So it's also known as filtration. The use of filtration is known as hardening the beam. Hardening the beam. So when you say hardening the beam, it's because You want the short, hard, penetrating rays to go through versus the long, low, soft energies. You don't want those. Long, soft, bad. Short, hard, good, right? So filtration is removing the lower energies before they actually strike the patient. So again, filtration is designed to get rid of the energies that are not useful. So previously we just said filtration is used to even out the x-ray beam, correct? That's for compensating filters. But when you go back to inherent and added and total filtration, it is designed to remove the lower energies before they strike the patient. Okay, I want to make sure I add that today. Again, we have inherent, we have added, and if you add those two together, we have total filtration. And for any machine that operates above 70 kVp, under NCRP number 102, all right, we have 2.5 millimeter aluminum equivalent. Again, I'm hoping this quick little tutorial is gonna help you understand inherent, added, and total filtration. Thank you. Hello everyone, you guys. Thank you very much for watching the videos. I'm hoping that they're helping you out. Please make sure that you subscribe and that you hit the notification bell to be notified about new videos. Again, remember to be good to yourself and be good to others. Thank you.